spaceship out of the way of the water.
Ah! Oh, hey!
Children, we have landed in the stomach of Bunty.
I didn't know our stomach looks like this from inside.
What do we do now? How will we get out of here?
I'm frightened.
Don't worry, kids. Nothing will happen to us. We will find a way out of Bunty's body.
Children, cheer up. It's not every day that you get to see inside a human body. So why not take this advantage and explore and see what makes a human body from inside.
That's a great idea. Hey children, Vayu is right. We are going to have a great time.
Okay children, let's look around us. As I told you, we are in the stomach of Bunty. Look, the walls of his stomach are sending out special juices. These juices are called acids. The acids then mix with the apple he has eaten and break it down into smaller pieces. So you see, children, we should always chew our food properly so that it gets easily broken down in our stomach.
What happens to the apple?
The small pieces of the apple stay in his stomach till the time they take the form of a liquid. Then, this liquid passes through an opening at the bottom of his stomach and finally goes into a long tube that we call the small intestine. See, this is how the small intestine looks in our body.
Just as water gushes down the drain of a bathtub, this liquid gushes down the small intestine. Let's enter the small intestine. Hold on, kids, here we go. Children, we have entered the small intestine. It is here in the small intestine that tiny bits of food move into the bloodstream. These tiny bits of food that are converted into liquid in the stomach are the ones the body can use for energy. Energy to keep us active.
But why do we call it small intestine? Is it because it is small?
Not exactly. Children, as you can see, the small intestine is in the form of a bundle. Now suppose we hold this in a straight line, you will be surprised to know that the small intestine runs 20 feet long.
Wow, that's really long.
That is why food particles take 8 hours to travel all the way through the small intestine. Do you know, kids? The small intestine lets only very small bits of food to pass through its wall.
Thank you.
So what happens to the larger particles?
Larger particles are so big that our body cannot use it. In other words, they become useless for our body. So our body sends these larger particles into this wider tube that we call large intestine. See, this is how the large intestine looks. From the large intestine, they leave our body as solid waste when we go to the toilet every morning. Children, we have now entered the bloodstream of Bunty. Let's see what lies inside.
Hey, look at those red and white things floating.
Maya, what are those red and white things in the blood?
The red discs are called the red blood cells, or RBC in short. The red blood cells are very important because they carry food and oxygen to the muscles, the bones, and every part of our body.
And are the white ones called the white blood cells?
Yes, very good. Very good, Bobby. We call them white blood cells, or WBC in short. The white blood cells are like doctors in our body. Because the work of white blood cells is to fight disease and infections in our body.
Oh no! These white blood cells think we are germs and they're trying to get rid of us. Vayu, we'll have to get away from here before they harm us.
I'll try to shake them off. Everybody, hold on. Phew, that was really close. These white blood cells are supposed to protect Bunty, but they nearly put an end to us.
Vayu, we'd better move ahead before they come back for us again.
Oh no! What is that?
Vayu, Maya, are we in more trouble?
Don't worry. That's just the sound of Bunty's heart pumping blood all through his body. Children, heart is very important part of our body. It keeps us alive and works even when we are sleeping.
Maya, do tell us more about our heart.
Children, heart is a muscle that is very light in weight. Although the heart does a big job, it is quite small. Do you know how small it is?
No.
Close your hand and form a fist. Like this. Children, your heart is the size of your fist. Can you all now imagine how small your heart is?
Yes. It is so small, but is so powerful.
Yes, children. The heart is a powerful pump. If our heart was outside our body, it could shoot a jet of liquid 6 feet into the air.
Wow!
Bunty's heart. I can't wait to tell him that I was in his heart.
Bobby, then you should also know how the heart works, so you can explain that too.
Yes, tell me.
The heart muscles pumps blood through a tube called the aorta. The aorta is a blood vessel just like the one we've been traveling through. The only difference is that it is much bigger in size.
Okay.
Hey, what's happening? Bunty's heartbeat has suddenly increased.
Maya, are we in danger again?
No, dear. It's just that Bunty must be running. Whenever we run, our heartbeat increases and at the same time, our breathing increases too.
But why is he running?
He is such a naughty boy. Maybe someone must be chasing Bunty to teach him a lesson.
Let's go and check out the lungs now.
Such a strong wind. Is there a storm outside?
As I told you, Bunty must be breathing hard and the wind is just the air going in and out of Bunty's lungs as he breathes.
Maya, please tell us more about the lungs.
Lungs are two inflatable sacs like balloons. They are situated in the upper part of the chest. Together, the two lungs of an adult hold as much air as there is in a basketball. Children, air is a mixture of various gases. When a human breathes in, the lungs take in a gas called oxygen out of the air and puts it in the blood. The blood then carries the oxygen to the cells all over the body. These cells use this oxygen for energy. As the cells use the oxygen for energy, they make a waste gas called carbon dioxide. The lungs get rid of this waste gas when we humans breathe out.
The lungs must be working very hard because we breathe so fast.
That's right, children. Every part of our body, whether it is inside or outside, plays a very important role. And we should always try and keep them healthy, because if they are healthy, we are healthy.
Bunty is such a naughty boy. I want to see what is in his brain.
So, let's go to his brain. Look, kids, we are entering the brain of Bunty now. This is the brain of a human body. We can also call our brain the command center. Do you know why?
Why?
Because it is the brain that gives the human body the order to jump, run, sleep, giggle, feel love for family and friends, scratch, think, ask questions, breathe, eat, and to remember.
be naughty also, just like Bunty?
Yes, I think we have learned a lot traveling across the body of Bunty. Now children, let's go back to the mouth of Bunty and wait for him to open his mouth. As he opens his mouth, our spaceship will zoom out into the open.
Children, we are at Bunty's mouth. See closely. This is the tongue. When we eat something, we use our tongue, our teeth, and a liquid called saliva to turn the bites of food into tiny pieces so that our body can use the food for energy. Children, look at the tongue. The tongue is covered with taste buds. Different taste buds do different jobs. Like the taste bud at the tip of the tongue tells when something is sweet. Those at the back of the tongue tell when something is sour. Taste buds near the sides of the tongue let us know when a food is salty or when it is bitter.
Look, Bunty is opening his mouth.
But why is he closing his mouth again?
Children, I think he's going to sneeze. Get ready. This is our chance to get out into the world from Bunty's mouth.
Vayu, we are again going inside.
Hold on, everybody. It's just a matter of a few seconds. That was really an adventure.
Did you children enjoy the adventure?
Yes!
It was really very exciting.
And dangerous.
Do you all remember what we saw inside Bunty's body?
Vayu, I think we have had enough adventure for the day and it's time for us to come in our original size.
You are right, Maya.
Dream.
But we learned a lot
and enjoyed it too.
See, even Budo is saying that he also enjoyed it.
So children, Now we'll take leave from all of you. So long, children.
Thank you, Vayu.
Thank you, Maya.
You all are welcome, children. Goodbye and take care.
Goodbye, children.
Goodbye, Vayu.
Goodbye, Maya.
Come on, let's go home. All this excitement has made me hungry.
Tomorrow I am going to tell Bunty that I was inside your brain.
And in your lungs.
And in your small intestine.
I bet he will not know what a small intestine is.
Of things.